Oh, Thank you. so glad that Jesus set me free.
Baptism of the Holy Ghost with genuine leadership.
Yes.
Amen. And I believe tonight that we are led.
Yes.
You believe that you've been led to be here tonight? You see, even as the prophet said, even to have that desire to be in the house of God, being led by the Spirit. So when you come into those times you don't feel like it, and you look, that's when you have to resist that. Go against that. Because you know in those times there is a blessing that awaits. Well, let's just have church tonight. If you turn with me to Hebrews chapter 11.
That's
So good to get a chance to meet. I've met quite a few of you, and
yes,
some of you haven't, but if we don't get you on this time, we'll definitely have enough time.
Amen.
I believe it's in the near future.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. I know this is a familiar passage of reading, but you know, we want God to come on the scene tonight.
Yes.
And I know these are our new services, but I believe that we all are heading to a real great new service.
Hallelujah.
And so I'll say it like this tonight. If you can identify with a lot of these things that's preached, because you know sometimes when you're ministering things, sometimes we can get in the habit of saying, oh, I already know that, I've already heard that, I'm beyond that. How do you know God ain't testing you on your attitude? If you've already experienced that, hey, pull.
Hey.
Identify with it. Because you pulling and identifying can pull the presence of God just like a blanket right over somebody else. We don't have a new message. It's the same message. Jesus Christ. Amen. And letting God make himself real and discern the thoughts and hearts.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Verse 23. I want to say I appreciate Brother Anderson and the invitation. Brother Cadre, his family. We just certainly appreciate him in the Lord. So we just want to look here in verse 23. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw he was a proper child and they were not afraid of the king's commandments. Glory. You know, it's kind of a mystery. It says, by faith, Moses, when he was born. You see, the faith already was starting to slowly unfold. His parents didn't read him. His parents didn't raise him like a maybe. They didn't raise him in the sense that, well, he might serve the Lord someday. They had an assurance. They operated with an assurance that the same God who did the work in me is the same God who will do the work in them. By faith, Moses, verse 24, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season.
For a season. For a season.
Yeah. Not a long time, just a season.
Just a season.
You know, I'm only 40 years old. I know I look like I'm only 18, but... But 18 just seemed like yesterday to me. My. And time just goes right by. It's a season. It moves by. Verse 26. Esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt, for he had respect unto the recompense of the reward.
Oh, yeah.
I want you to notice verse 27, and then we'll let you be seated. By faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. Let's just bow our heads in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord, we are certainly so thankful that, Lord God, that you have brought us, Lord, into this great place, Lord. Father, beyond that of this building that we are seated in, Lord, into that place in Jesus Christ. And Lord, we ask, Lord, here tonight as we gather together, it's just for one purpose, Lord, and that's to see you, Father. And Lord, that you would come, Lord, and just, Lord, move as you would move sovereignly, Lord. Changing lives, dealing with hearts, setting people free, oh God, healing the sick, Lord God, casting out devils, Lord. Father, we ask it in the name of Jesus Christ, as we give ourselves to you, Lord, that you might have the right of way here, Lord, as speaker in here, Lord, that the word might be divinely placed, Lord, and speak, oh God, to our hearts, Lord, as you would see fit, Father. Lord, we give ourselves to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. God bless you as you've been seated. I'd like to speak to you on a little thought. And seeing that the Lord just dropped this really way back in May of my heart. I'd like to speak to you on realization and respect of the unseen.
Come on.
This word that we see here in verse 26, it speaks about Moses had respect unto the recompense of the reward. You know, the Bible said he esteemed the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt. Now, mind you that the treasures that were in Egypt were the very riches and wealth of the world.
Amen.
And so when we are speaking of the riches of Christ, there had to be something that Moses was able to see,
yes, sir,
that he recognized it held a greater,
amen,
value,
glory,
than all that he could,
amen,
see around him.
Hallelujah.
And so then by that, then as the scripture said, then he esteemed the riches of Christ. Once he seen the riches that he could have,
amen,
and the riches that could be a part of his life, he forsook others.
Amen.
The riches of this world, you know, as a young person, those things, they're moth, they're rust.
Come on, preach that.
Those things will pass away.
Yes, sir.
But the riches that are in Christ, they never fade. They never diminish. They are never devalued.
Come on,
preach that. They increase.
Yes, sir.
To turn the eyes away from other things,
amen,
and fix them on some one thing.
Amen.
To look with a steadfast mental gaze. And the Bible went on to say, verse 27, as we read, by faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible.
Amen.
That word, to see, to stare at, it means to perceive, to,
amen,
become acquainted with one by an experience.
Amen.
See, I got a question for you tonight, because when we look at the word, you know, this is a time and an age where people want to pick on words.
Right.
It said this here, it said this over here. But you see, when this scripture says that he endured as seeing him and who is invisible, I got a question. How do you see one who is invisible?
Preach that! Come on!
How that God will always bring down an open understanding with using things that you and I can relate to.
Yes, sir.
Right. Amen.
You see, as the prophet was moved there within his ministry, he began to speak. You know, he brought us to an awareness of the other dimensions that are influencing us right here. You know, a lot of times you think you're making your own decisions, and you are making choices, but there is something, someone who is influencing you.
Amen.
You might look and say, well, I'm doing this because I want to do it.
No,
the reality is, you might see a certain style and you start wearing that style. Now, I'm going to say it like this. When I was growing up, I cared about how my hair looked. I don't have it now, I'll get it back. But you see, now I look around and I see their ones, and I'm picking on nobody. But I look around and I say, they look like they just got out of bed. Yeah.
room right here, there are signals that's going. And, you know, Brother Ben used the example over and over about the television signal. And he spoke about how that, you know, he said, them signals, those colors are flying all through this room. And he said that your whole being, our being right now, we're subject here into these five senses. I can't see television waves coming through here. You can't either. I mean, I don't know if you got Wi-Fi in the church, but you can't see Wi-Fi flying through here. You don't even see the signal flying out of this box and flying back out. But yet you know it's doing it. Man, how do you know? Because you hear that voice coming across. So you know there is a transmission and there's a receiver somewhere.
Tap in, trying to tap in the
thing.
But God himself has set it up that God
No doubt. Probably every young person in here, you got a cell phone.
All right.
No doubt. Was growing up?
No, sir.
After Fisher Price, I had no phone. I mean, you had the home. You had the phone phone that you had to have. Can I call? Maybe that some of us have, and I can give that cell phone to you.
Come on.
Now let's say it's a smartphone. That smartphone, you could look at it, and maybe you could hook it up to the Wi-Fi, and you'd be able to kind of surf the internet and whatever more. But there's things, some things about it, you couldn't make phone calls on it. Yet it has everything in it to be able to do it. But what it is, that which is in it, that SIM card, has got to get activated.
Amen.
When that SIM card gets activated, then you can start making calls and receiving calls.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I'm going to call that SIM card the seed of God.
Serving me.
Yeah.
You say,
you know. I can pull up the news just like you can.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And up there in the city where I live right next to, it's like mayhem since they won that championship.
Yeah.
And I tell you what, you think it's been worship before of LeBron James. It's real worship now.
Yeah.
Having LeBron James celebration in Akron.
Uh-huh.
You see, this is the thing. Let him have all of that. You see, the world itself, the spirit behind the world, it resists humility. It says, I can make it on my own way. I can do it on my own way. I can serve God in my own way. I can make it on my own way. You can't make it on your own way. If you could make it on your own way, then he wouldn't have had to come down and get on the way to hell. He is the way. He is the way. He has said he has made known to me the path, the way to God, and that is Jesus Christ. To look around and see snowy screen. You know I'm trying to do somebody trying to fix it. And how in the world can we sit around with a fuzzy screen? It's okay looking through things like a fuzzy screen. God didn't intend you to look at things through a fuzzy screen. He intended you to see him for who he is, that you might see yourself for who you are. These television signals, the cell phone signals, my body ain't set to pick it up, neither is yours.
That's right.
Come on.
You know, it's like, you know, Brother Jackson asked me today, we were exchanging numbers. You know what I did? I gave him my dad's number. Cell phones have done a mess on us, I tell you.
Yes, sir.
Before somebody asks you, what's your home number? Said, honey, what's our home number?
Yeah.
No numbers anymore. So here he is calling. You know, trying to get the number picked up so he can put it in the contact. He's calling me. I ain't got no call. He said, he ain't coming through. No, not yet.
Great, Father. Call him.
He quotes to me the last four digits of the number. I said, oh, my Lord. I gave you my dad's number. I said, no, erase that. I said, my dad's probably wondering who's calling me from South Carolina. But you see, you got to have the right numbers. You got to get locked into the right pathway. It isn't just enough to have the number. You gotta have them in the right order! And that's exactly, God is a God of order! If you just submit yourself to Him, He'll order your life! I'm gonna tell you, He's already had His hand on your life. What kind of knowing not? You're bumping into things.
Yeah. Right?
You wonder why I'm bumping into this. There's another world you're bumping into. And what it is, there's others that are around. You wonder why. Well, I don't seem like I can fit in with the rest of these people. You know, you try. You and me both. I try.
You try.
I put on, you know, the right polo symbol. I talk to your figure. You know, make sure I had it on my.
Come on, come on.
you ought not be doing. And you bump into it and plans fall through.
Hallelujah.
That's another word you're bumping into. It's God protecting you. You say, give me an example. I'm glad you asked for that. You know the prophet that withstood this pressure? Remember, here he was around with some older people. You know how it is, you get around older people? You know, people you got a lot of respect for. He was around, and what would he say? That friend of his dad said something about him. And what did his dad say? He ain't gonna take no drink. I raised all of them, and out of all of them, he's the biggest sister.
That's what he said! That's exactly what he said!
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh.
Let me tell you something, it matters what you say, parents.
Yes, sir.
But you know what he had to do? He tried to do it, but he wouldn't let him.
Now,
you might say, well, I took a drink. I smoked a drunk.
Yes, sir.
I listened to this. I did that. But why was I allowed to do it? Hold on a moment. Why was it that God didn't let you stay in that? Coming this way, I'm going to get his attention.
Amen. Amen.
I want you to think about it. How many times you and I have went by mile markers, post markers,
come on,
and things that we failed when somebody said, hey, did you see that? He said, see what?
Nope.
Didn't see it.
Amen.
Yeah, yeah. You would think somebody said, well, last time the world you miss it.
Well,
I said, I don't know. I just didn't see it. Maybe you should have told me. Come on. You see what God had confidence in? God had confidence in when he would be.